Reach out to our family, friends, and co-workers. That is the wisdom of today's reading on the High Priestess's Circle. Greetings, everyone. I'm Oblyron, the Lord of Love and the Magister of the Cube. Thank you for joining me on today's Elemental Synastry reading. It's a technique that I devised which incorporates the tarot, astrology, and the five elements. So let's see what's happening with the element of spirit, which is represented by the bell. All right. Okay. All right, we got the Six of Wands. All right, very good, very good. So spirit is in a victorious state, or at least there is something that is about to manifest, which will be victorious, or the likely outcome of victory is imminent. And again, it hasn't manifested yet, but it's right there, just like how a lot of things are on the tip of our tongue. It's about to manifest. So let's see what the astrology die have to recommend so we can bring this victory into manifestation. Okay, we have, all right, we've got the South Node in Virgo in the sixth house. All right, let's line this up. So I roll first for the house, and then I roll a second time for the Deccan. 12. All right. Ooh, okay. And it's also in Leo, which is the sixth house. So what's interesting is, in order to be victorious, we have to return to our South Node, which usually life's lessons have to do with dealing with the North Node. But in this particular instance, it's saying, look back to our South Node in order to be victorious. Let's learn the karmic lessons of the past in order to manifest this victory that wants to manifest within the spirit, but it has not quite come to fruition on the earth yet. And with it being in Virgo in the 12th house, so that is the family card, or I should say the Lord of, let's see if I remember correctly, it is the Lord of material wealth. So it involves a total package when it comes to wealth. And as we know, wealth is not just about us making money as individuals, but it is also being able to be wealthy in the familial sense, to have our loved ones around us, and to be able to share that wealth with our family. Otherwise, you know, we become like Ebenezer Scrooge. And this is saying, remember where you came from. Remember that in the past, we were wealthy. We had what we needed. And let's not forget the values that our families try to instill in us in order to manifest that victory within the spirit. So this is also telling me that it has to do a lot with the ancestors. The ancestors are saying, don't forget us. Always know that we are there watching you and we are there guiding you too. And with it being in the house of Leo, or I should say the sixth house, which is influenced by Leo, with it being in that house, it also relates to our entertainment and having fun. So it's saying, look, remember that we as families used to laugh and love together. Times may not have always been perfect, but that was when we were our most wealthy. That's the lesson that the ancestors are trying to tell us. So I think this is very much going to be an ancestral reading today. Again, spirit leads the reading, and I don't know exactly where it's going to go, but yeah, this seems to be, I can tell already that we're headed in that direction. It's going to be a message from our ancestors. Okay, so let's moving right along. After the spirit comes the fire. The fire begins to guide us divinely. It fuels our human spirit, and it fuels our ambition. So what is the element of fire being influenced by? And again, wands is representative of the fire. Okay. Ace of Wands. All right. So we have a lot of fire energy coming in. It's saying, manifest that enterprise, manifest that drive, manifest that spirit. Reconnect with the spirit in order to bring about this victorious manifestation that wants to happen. Ace of Wands, it's really great when starting a new enterprise, starting a new endeavor. We're getting a lot of fire here from the Six of Wands, from the House of Leo, and from the Ace of Wands, of course, influencing the fire. So, yeah, definitely a lot of tapping into that human spirit, tapping into the ambition, to our drive, to discovering what motivates us. Okay, what do the astrology die have to recommend to us? Okay, we got... Wow, that happened again. What is going on here? This is really interesting. Okay, let's swap this out. I swear these things are changing on me. It's so weird. Okay. Alright, let's do that and that. Yeah, I had these all set up and ready to go, and then all of a sudden... Yeah, I had two number die right next to each other, and it's like... It's really hard to mess that up. Those were not like that. Really interesting. Okay. Alright, so we have Neptune in Pisces in the ninth house. Alright. Neptune in Pisces in the ninth house. Very interesting. Okay, let's re-roll for the Deccan. 11. Alright. Okay. This is really cool. This is a really interesting reading. So with Neptune influencing Pisces, I mean, it's already the ruler of the house of Pisces. In the 11th decan, that's called the Lord, or I'm sorry, in the 3rd decan, that's called the Lord of Perfected Success. It is the joy card. It is, and again, it's a very powerful card, and it's a very powerful card influencing a very powerful tarot card. So here we have, again, a lot of fire energy, because the ninth house is Sagittarius. It relates to higher learning, it relates to study, it relates to our philosophies. It is saying to look towards our mysticism in order to rediscover that joy, that familial joy within us too. And again, 30, 60, 90, 120, looks like we have a trine happening. Wow, okay. So we have both the spirit and the element of fire in a trine, which means that both of these work in perfect synastry to help bring about the manifestation. Again, our ancestors are telling us, don't forget them, remember how times were, remember our karmic debts that we have learned, don't forget the family, and the fire is saying, don't forget to be spiritual, to educate yourself in spiritual matters in order to manifest that human spirit, in order to amplify those endeavors that we are trying to attain. And again, Neptune is also the hangman. It represents being in a state of suspension. So detachment from the physical world. And we need to detach ourselves from the physical world in order to bring about our higher education. So this is a very spiritual reading. And we are looking at being able to tap into these energies to manifest that ultimate joy. That's the third decan of Pisces, which is... It could be called the joy card. It's the Lord of Perfected Success. It's one of the most... It's a very powerful card in the tarot deck. And the astrology die are suggesting that as well. And again, with it being a trine, we find that these energies work very well together. So, ancestors in the spirit realm, higher knowledge in the spiritual realm is what we're getting so far. Okay, moving right along. We have air. So when the spirit begins to manifest, it goes to our intellect and communication. We need that flash of inspiration before we're able to draw upon and to put it into application through the element of air, which again is understanding things intellectually and also being able to communicate those ideas with which we understand. Okay, so what is the element of air being influenced by? Okay, Five of Wands. All right, so right now we are seeing that there is a competition. The spirit has a lot of competing ideas, and that conflict could be stalling our communication. So the advice from this, what I can tell so far, is in order to get these to fully manifest, we must resolve the conflict within ourselves. Okay, let's see what the astrology die have to say. And let me double check this. Okay, they're right now. Wow, another South Node. Okay, so South Node in Gemini in the 10th house. Okay. South Node in Gemini in the 10th house. Let's see what decan we're in. 11. So that is the third decan of Gemini. Okay, oh wow, very interesting. Okay, so what I'm getting from this is we are going back to the South Node, which means we are going back to the past, our past lives, our past karmic debts that we have paid. Apparently, we're forgetting them again, and it is saying to resolve this conflict, we must look to the past, and we must also let it go. The third decan of Gemini is the Lord of Ruin, and the whole point of the Lord of Ruin is to learn the lessons so that we can be reborn. The third decan is also an ending, an ending card as well. And with it being in the 10th house, with that has to relate to career and success and status, it's basically saying to resolve the conflict within the past so that we can move ahead with our careers, so that we can move ahead with working those jobs, working our higher calling, working those things which bring us that material abundance. All right. So apparently we've forgotten a lot of the lessons of the past. We've forgotten the lessons to honor the ancestors, and we've forgotten the lessons of how to give our lives meaning through our work in what we choose to do. So a lot of us, I know a lot of people, I've read on a lot of Reddits and on a lot of social media that a lot of people feel like they're not working their life path in their jobs and in their careers. And again, there's a lot of conflict. There is a lot of things which need to be resolved. So we need to understand those intellectually in order to be able to communicate. Remember, it's not just about communicating to others, but it's also communicating to ourselves what we truly need when it comes to the element of air. There's a lot of confusion. There's a lot of mental confusion in what we're supposed to do. So again, look to the lessons of the past, leave it in the past, so that we can be reborn into something better. Okay, and let's see. All right, we still have our trine. We got nothing else forming yet. All right. Pentacles is the next element. Now, all of these are also based off of the Tree of Yggdrasil. So the spirit encompasses everything. The element of fire represents the branches, or I'm sorry, the spirit encompasses everything, so does fire. The element of air represents the branch of Yggdrasil. And that's basically when the elements of the spirit begin to give us divine inspiration so that we can understand it on an intellectual level. It's the upper branches, and with the pentacles, we are now moving into the trunk of Yggdrasil, which also represents the body, and it also represents our material condition as well. Okay. So, what is influencing pentacles? What's influencing our material wealth? The Tower. All right. So, essentially what's happening, and it's relating back to the Lord of Ruin right here, is there has to be a lot of change. The Tower is also, in astrological terms, represented by Mars. So there is something within our drive and our identity which needs to change to be able to manifest in that material world. And again, with all this conflict and what to do with our careers and what to do with our job, it makes sense that the material realm is not quite what it needs to be. So we have pentacles being influenced by the Tower. Now, what do the astrology die have to recommend to us? Okay, we have Pluto in Libra in the seventh house. Okay. Oh, seventh house. All right. I'll get it one of these days. Okay. Very interesting. And let's reroll for the Deccan. Okay, eight. Okay. So, very interesting. So we have the Tower, which is calling for drastic change, and we also have Pluto, which is basically a transformation, a drastic transformation. So there's a lot of transformation that needs to happen in the material world. And here it is, since it's in Libra, we have a lot of influence with our interpersonal relationships. The middle decan is the Lord of Sorrow, which is governed by Saturn. So essentially what it's saying is we need to restructure our interpersonal relationships. And it's really interesting how this also ties back in with the whole message of spirit, in that we need to go back and recognize our ancestors and the trials of the past, and also our past lives too. Very interesting. So not only on the spirit level do we need to recognize the people in our lives, but also on the physical level, we need to recognize the people in our lives. We need to reestablish those harmonious relationships, especially with the people closest to us. And because it's tied in with career, I would also say reestablishing harmonious relationships with our coworkers and our peers. There's a lot of disconnect right now in our reality, and that disconnect is basically what is diminishing the success for all of us. When, you know, they always say, show me five of your friends and I'll show you your future. Well, a lot of people, statistically speaking, don't really, and I've learned this from cell phone experiments, cell phone statistics, is that a lot of people only call perhaps maybe one or two people a month on average. And if we don't even have five friends in our real life to help us get to where we want to be, or to even have that emotional support, then we are not successful. So it makes sense to me that Pluto and the Tower is saying, look, we need drastic change. We need to restructure our interpersonal relationships. And we also need to focus that with the Lord of Ruin in our careers. Again, the Lord of Ruin is to learn the lessons to be reborn. So yeah, it's starting to really come together. Let's see. We also have, okay, now this is also very interesting. We also have a square happening between both the element of air and the element of earth. So our ideas and our material well-being are in conflict with each other, which makes a lot of sense because, again, our interpersonal relationships need to be restructured, and our careers and how we choose to, our calling in life is also in conflict. Both of these in conflict are squaring each other, so that creates additional conflict between the two. And what's the lesson here? Look to the spirit, look to the element of fire, which is our ambitions. So these two elements are actually very powerful. I think by looking to a higher power and looking, again, on matters of a more spiritual nature, we'll be able to put these two elements, both air and pentacles, more in alignment with what we need. All right, so moving right along. Cups. Cups represent water. Cups represent the emotion. And cups also represent the lower, or the roots of the tree of Yggdrasil. It represents our ancestors. It represents that which we inherit from our ancestors. And let's see, what do cups have to say? What is cups being influenced by? Ah, okay. So we have Seven of Pentacles. All right, let me put this over here. Seven of Pentacles is the Lord of Unfulfilled Success. It is, or it can also be called the Perseverance card. It has to deal with delayed gratification in our material realm. And that makes a lot of sense because we have a lot of conflict in the material realm here. Not only with pentacles, but also in the element of air of what we even want to do with our lives. And so our emotional state is such that we have all put in a lot of time and effort to our emotional state, but we have not yet seen or manifested the rewards of that emotional state. We are still struggling. However, it's a bit of a hopeful card. It just says to keep on keeping on. You know, things, it's not going to be about instant gratification here when it comes to fully manifesting that joy within our emotional state. We're going to have to still put in the work. The Seven of Pentacles is also guided by the planet Saturn as well. So a lot of Saturnian energy here, a lot of energy which calls for a lot of change and rebirth. All right, so what do the astrology die have to recommend? Okay, we have Venus in Virgo, in the first house. Ooh, right there, first house. Let's re-roll for the Deccan. 10. Okay, so that is the Three of Wands. All right. Okay. So what's very interesting, well, it's not the Three of Wands, my bad. We have again the family card again. And I'm sorry, that's not Venus, that's Mercury. Sorry. So we have the family card again. And it's influenced by Virgo, which again is service to others. And with Mercury being the planet also influencing that, it's essentially suggesting that in order to communicate effectively, or in order to effectively manifest this emotional wealth with the cups, we need to learn how to communicate to our families again, and in order to experience that abundance and that material wealth. Okay, let's see, 30s. And again, we have, wow, oh wow, okay. We have a trine between spirit, fire, and water. Okay, first time I've ever seen a trine like that. So all of these are connected. It's basically a grand trine. And this is screaming at me. Ancestors, family, enterprise, all of it. Manifest it all. It screams understanding your spiritual nature, understanding, reconnecting with the lessons of the past, and learning how to communicate with the people of the present. Again, it's not going to be an easy road to rebuild and foster those relationships, especially for a lot of us, but it still needs to be done. Again, here, it's also influenced by Libra, and we have an opposition here. So these have not quite worked in conjunction yet, but it needs to be addressed. We have the family here. We have interpersonal relationships here. Wow, we got all kinds of stuff happening. So again, reconnecting. And Aries is the first house, which is our outward persona. So look to things which we can help to refine our outward persona. In order to be the emperor, we must go back and study ourselves. It all starts with ourselves first. And we need to take that initiative with ourselves to go out and reach out to others. Other people aren't going to reach out to us. We need to be the ones to initiate that contact. And again, Mercury in Virgo, in the third decan of Virgo. Mercury is also exalted in Virgo. So at least there's a little bit of ease of communication there. All right. Wow, so this is really interesting. Okay. Yeah, definitely our familial and our interpersonal relationships. And again, it's not just familial. In our careers as well, we need to reestablish those lines of communication with our coworkers too. So basically, everyone in our lives, we need to learn to be better too. Okay? We need to call up people and ask how they're doing. We need to basically say, hey, are you doing all right? Is there anything I can do for you? Virgo, in both of these, is again service to others. It's not about ourselves when it comes to this. It's about service to others. And a lot of it also has to do with health too. And it would suggest that the health of our relationships, of our interpersonal relationships, is in a rather poor state, which makes sense because here's Pluto calling for change in our interpersonal relationships, and here's the Lord of Ruin calling for change in our career and in how we deal with our coworkers too. Again, get rid of the conflict, get rid of the ego battles and all that kind of stuff. We're all humans at the end of the day, and we need to first remember that we're all here for each other, as opposed to having it just be about me, 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 okay? All right, I think that's about good enough for now. If you got something from this, I hope you'll stay around and for next week on the next reading. Again, this is a timeless collective reading. It transcends time and space. And if you resonate with this message at any point, then this message is for you. Okay, thank you all for joining me on the High Priestess's Circle, and hope to see you all again soon. Bye-bye. Thank you for joining us on today's episode. If you resonate with what you are seeing or hearing, please take a moment to like, subscribe, and share Oblyron's content. It really helps him to spread the word and to grow his channel and pages. Collective readings are posted Mondays on the High Priestess's Circle. Teachings are posted Wednesdays on the Magister's Sanctum, and the music from those episodes are posted Fridays on the Empress's Theater. Posters and merch related to Oblyron's teachings are available at oblyron.square.site. Music from the episodes is also available at oblyron.bandcamp.com. Oblyron is spelled O-B-L-Y-R-O-N. Lastly, don't forget to connect with the community on Discord. It's called the Magister's Council, and look for the invite link in the description boxes and profiles below. There are astrology and wellness bots, as well as games and discussion forums available for free. There is also an exclusive members-only section with additional content and live streams for subscribers. Oblyron also takes inquiries for services through Discord. In case you missed anything, all the links are available in the description boxes and profiles below. Thank you, everyone, and much love to all.